Okay, we just got our Turgo in from Spencer at Langston's Alternative Energy, and we're going to have to build a frame to hold it, but looking forward to getting this thing up and running. Okay, here's the Turgo upside down. The Turgo wheels have a little different geometry than the Pelton wheels. We've got two nozzles. It's going to be a dual. Right now we got our nozzles at 22 millimeters. And that's it. We're going to run these three leads about 250 feet to a rectifier, to a bridge rectifier, and convert to DC and take that to our charge controller so we can charge a battery bank. And we're going to be basically working on a 24 volt system for overall for this gentleman. So anyway, I just wanted you to see the, before we put it in operation, so you could see the Turgo, see the design. Fairly straightforward, pretty simple. So we got to come up with a way to anchor this thing off to the side of the creek to protect it from heavy rains and just secure it so we can fasten our input lines. We're going to adapt from 4-inch PVC down to 1.5-inch NPT, and we might use some flexible hoses to do that and some coupling, so you'll see. Coming up. Okay, here we are on the inlet side. We got a repurposed sluice box, and we've just been playing around with the rocks and things. We're going to put some sides on the sluice box, get some of the air away from the intake, and slow things down, get as much water as possible. But it's doing pretty good. It's pretty flooded right now at the inlet of the 4-inch pipe. So we think we're pretty good for now for temporary setup. Good trying. Okay, we got a 13/16 nozzle on here. We're shooting it a long ways. I would say about 20, at least 20 feet, and we should be about 11 psi. That's where we were before. Didn't zoom in that far. I think we're just about hitting 11 psi. Oops, sorry about the video.
Okay, we're continuing with this hydroelectric project using a Turgo wheel. Today we're going to attempt to mount this Turgo to a rock. So I've welded up a frame that we're going to mount to support our turbine. And then we've got some cam locks that we're going to use to feed the water into the turbine through the two nozzles. We'll have shutoffs on each line. So we're going to adapt from 4-inch down to 2-inch down to the, I think these are 22 millimeter nozzles, and that kind of was optimized by Spencer over at Langston's Alternative Energy for this setup. So basically what I do is measure the flow rate and the pressure, or the total dynamic head for the project, and that allows us to design your turbine. Again, this is a Turgo, so we're dealing with more volume and less head. So we only have about 30 feet of head in this one. So, okay, we're going to mount this to the rock. If you want to look down here at the rock, our goal is to put the Turgo mounted to that mossy covered rock. So we've hammer drilled some holes in there, gonna wedge anchor it and see if we can make some power today. Okay, we've got our Turgo turbine mounted on a frame. We've got our three-phase AC coming off of the generator to a rectifier. And our goal is to get we want to charge a 24 volt battery bank. So we've got two nozzles coming in on this Turgo wheel under here. I'm going to have to do some nozzle adjustment. I'm going to turn them on here for our shutoffs. Just drink some water here. Turn the second one on. Okay, we're finishing up our Turgo microhydro setup here, and we are pretty excited to have it running today. Take a look at it. We've done a few modifications to it. We've cut out the bottom of the frame to get a little better flow,
and we've run our wire, we've made our connection, we're about 300 feet from where we're actually going to have the battery. That'll be part two, where we actually hook this thing to a midnight SID start controller, Magnum inverter, and tie it into the house. But today we're so happy to get power. We're going to get some actual power. Things running, mounted to the rock. Another hot day here in an undisclosed location, but we're having fun making power off of water.
Okay, here's the rectifier, three-phase AC coming in from the Turgo about 300 feet away. We've got 300 feet of number 10. It's 10-3. What is it? It's wire. It's late in the day. And I'm bringing three-phase AC into this rectifier and converting it into DC. Get on these terminals here. And I'm at 47.4 volts. My goal today was 48. I'm 0.4 volts away. So we need to work on the intake a little bit more. I think we can get 50 volts out of this. I'll be very happy. We're charging a 24 volt battery bank. And I believe the rule of thumb, if you can double your open circuit voltage, that's a great place to start charging your battery bank. So a special shout out to Spencer Langston at Langston's Alternative Energy. He's helped me. He's the one that built this turbine, and we worked together to size the nozzles. And so we're in good shape. We're only maybe a volt off from what he tested on his test bench. So if you need any help with microhydro, check out Spencer. You can go through me, and we'll get you hooked up. This sure beats being up on a roof putting solar panels up. I love playing in the creek. I never grew up. This is a modified sluice box. It's got some double screening on it. You can see our source of water. Come in here. There's actually more water, so I think we can raise the voltage up a little bit, get a little better flow. So just a modified sluice box. I know it doesn't look pretty, but we know that we can make enough power off of this stream to do what we need to do with this Turgo. We just gonna have to make this better. There's some really fancy Coanda screen for hydro, very expensive. So this is a great start. We know there's enough power on this creek to do what it needs to do. So. Okay, I'm signing off for the 15th time. If you need any help with any alternative energy projects, just let me know. It's Engineer 775, signing off.